Hello everyone, I'm Amber. Today I'll show you how to set up Flink on Docker. I found a GitHub repository and all the operations we're going to show you is based on it. Now first, let's check my environment. We can see I'm using CentOS 7.9. Before we start, make sure we have Docker installed. Check my Docker version and Docker Compose version. Next, we're going to start Docker. We can check Docker status now. Docker is running. It's active. Next, let's clone the repository. Let's go into the folder and start the Docker Compose. This command will pull all the three containers, and it may take a while if it's the first time you're running this command. So I speed up this part. And now, we're done. We can see all the three containers are started. It's a job manager, task manager, and SQL client. Let's double check by using Docker Compose PS. Now the containers are running. And now we can use Flink Swap UI. Open your browser, type your IP colon Flink port number. I use the default number 8081. Here is the Flink dashboard. We're on the overview page. We can see jobs, running job or completed jobs. Next, task managers. We can see the task service we just started. Now we're in Java Manager. You can see metrics, configuration, or log. This is the Submit New Job tab. Back to the overview page again. Now, before we go to the next step, I want to show some tips about the Docker Compose. Let's check the YAML file. And we can see that I map settings subfolder to the job manager Docker container. And I map data subfolder to task manager and job manager containers too. This is because I need to provide the SQL example next. Now we enter the SQL client container. We use ps to find its name and run this command to enter it. Bin bash. Here we go. And we can start SQL client with this script. Now we're in. Before we load data, I'll show you the data I'm going to use. We open data, test. Oh, oops. It doesn't work. Let's use with. Okay, we can see the data. And now let's go back to Flink SQL client. We create a table and load the test.csv file. Succeed. Now we can query the table. For example, we select all the data from the table. This is the result. We can see the five rows of data. Now we press quit. And now let's exit the SQL client and container. That's all for today. Hope you enjoy it. And I'll see you very, very soon. Bye bye.